Hey guys, lepedaler back with another video. Today I'm going to be looking at Rohan Dennis's TT bike. He is the current world time trial champion and he's riding for Team Ineos this season and he's riding a Pinarello Bolide TT bike. So let's look at his specs and let's see what the world champion is riding this season. So just to give you guys some quick background knowledge on Rohan Dennis, he was riding for Bardi Morita last season and he had a kind of a falling out with his team because there was a stage in the Tour de France where he was supposed to ride for one of the GC contenders, but actually he had a time trial the next day that he was supposed to win because TTs are his thing. So that forced him to actually abandon the Tour de France because of that. And not only that, he throughout the whole season, he didn't like the Morita TT bike that he was given just compared to what he was riding before, which was a BMC TT bike. So when he actually went to the Yorkshire World Championships, he actually got an unbranded BMC TT bike. So that's how much he hated Bardi Morita's bike that they gave him. So for that reason, it's nice to see him at least this season on a bike that will actually be functional for a world champion. And that's the funny thing where he actually, for winning the world championships, everything he complained about had reason because, you know, to be the world's best, you have to have some level of decent equipment. So it's kind of unfortunate that happened, but at least, you know, 2020 positivity, he's on a better team, better bike manufacturer in his opinion. So let's keep watching the video and see what specs he actually has. So looking at the bike, you can see that it's very clean and aesthetically pleasing. It has the world rainbow bands on it and they are sponsored by Shimano, Pinarello as well, and pro equipment for the rear, which is Shimano also. And they have, I'm pretty sure their handlebar sponsor is Pinarello's subsidiary brand Most. So just looking at it, they have an elite bottle cage at the very bottom, which is looks more aerodynamic than their usual bottles, and they have an upper mount as well, but you wouldn't be using that for a TT race anyways. So yeah, just looking at the bike, it's very very clean. I'm the type of rider that likes minimalistic. I don't like a lot of bling bling, but yeah, so look at the handlebars. We can actually see he has some grip tape, and like I said, they are sponsored by Most. And we can see a Garmin head unit mount, and what else? Yeah, a lot of stack heights. So yeah, like I was saying, a lot of stack heights. So it goes vertically like this, and then horizontal upwards, and that allows him to get into more of a forward position, which actually is proven to be more power output producing than compared to a more forward aerodynamic position. And you can see if we look back to even older times, during the early Tour de France days, 80s, 90s, you can see that this lift bike I was able to find, look how aggressive and forward aerodynamic that position is. And if you look 5 years ago to Fabio Cancellara, you can see he's very forward as well. So it's very interesting to see with the advancement of sports science and testing, and with the barriers of testing going down, you can see that, you know, the best compromise is one that's a little bit more upwards, maybe not the most aerodynamic, but it allows you to produce more power because of the position you are. Instead of being more forward, you're more upward. But so it's like the compromise of aero versus power, and that's what the position that we have today. And Rohan's position is very similar to a lot of the positions we see in the pro peloton right now. So very interesting. You can see his pads are pretty normal, not very thin, not very cushiony. So just pretty normal. Like I was saying, they have a Garmin mount at the very front. That's probably professionally glued on by the mechanics. He has some tape also there to block any of the spacing. So Durace buttons on the side, DI2, that's probably all internally routed cable. Yeah, you can actually see the cable. So they had to, the cable comes out a little bit and then it goes internally routed. And he has no bar tape and it's grip tape. So you can see he's running Shimano Durace DI2 on the bike. And he has a 5644 as his chain rings, pretty normal, not anything super big. And he has 1130 for the rear. These are pretty standard gearings because a lot of people, I would say majority of riders in the pro peloton are spinning. So, you know, no more grinding. And now you can see the rear has a drop belt that reminds me of one of the track bike. And this one's actually aluminum because If you had it in carbon, you risk warping it, because when you do TT races, you do a lot of torquing. So having it in aluminum ensures that it won't actually warp, and just the longevity of the life gets extended. So that's the rear look of the chain line. You can also see on the fork, it actually has these two wings, which probably help with aerodynamics, letting the wind flow over that. So it's kind of like little wings. You can actually see that these brake calipers are not made by Shimano. These are specially made by Pinarello for the Bolide, which is the bike he's riding. So the saddle is actually made by Physique, and the tires are produced by Continental. And if you guys are curious about the rims, they're usually either made by Pro or Durace, and depends if they have the tri-spoke at the front or the back. And in this situation, he has 60 millimeters for the front. Like I said, Physique saddle. So if we actually go back, you can actually see there's a K-edge chain catcher, just to ensure that, you know, if he's in the small ring, that he won't drop his chain. And overall, just a very good looking bike. You can actually see from this view that it is a Physique saddle. And just a very clean bike. It's hopefully a bike that he's gonna get a lot of wins, and hopefully he can go back to back for maybe a three-peat, I'm not sure. Very, very minimalistic. I really like it overall. Overall, a very clean bike. You can see that those are the old bands, and that's the date in Yorkshire. That's how long it took him, the date it happened, and the location where it took place. So overall, not a bad bike. Obviously the World Championship is something very important, so having the best equipment is something that's key. Something to note is his bike actually weighs 8 kilograms and 17 pounds. If you guys aren't weight weenies, those are the stats. And other than that, pretty light actually for a TT bike. So guys, if you did enjoy the video, please smash the like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe. If you guys want to see more videos or have any ideas, please leave them in the comment section below. And until then, keep pedaling.